As Uganda joins the globe to observe World Mental Health Day under the theme, Mental Health is a Universal Human Right. We speak to Dr. Juliet Naku, the Executive Director of Butabika Hospital, to understand the leading factors of mental health-related illnesses.
Health-related things that may cause mental ill health. For example, trauma to the head, traumatic brain injury. So these accidents that we're getting left, right, and center may be throwing some people into mental ill health. Infections, severe infections like malaria to the brain, COVID to the brain, HIV. Actually, when HIV came, also we saw a spike. So viral infections that end up in the brain may lead to a lot of mental ill health. We have other health conditions. If you have tumors in the brain, generally general physical health can affect mental health. But environmental or psychosocial factors may also trigger mental health problems. Like relationship problems, stress basically, stress from any cause. If it is excessive and not well dealt with, and if there is no avenue to deal with it, it can actually tip someone into mental illness and they end up in a hospital. Or it can tip them into excessively using drugs, and those drugs will affect mental health. And of course, the other thing is excessive alcohol and addictive drug use. That is causing a lot of mental ill health of young people.
Dr. Naku explains the pre- and post-COVID effect on the mental health of this country. She says this was a big challenge to many people.
Many people were worried about the economic situation that was going out of control during and after COVID. The lockdowns separated people because people had to keep away from their social networks, which is normally what people do for a good mental health. But now, everyone had to keep it to themselves. Particularly people who live alone had a problem. So while these conditions existed before COVID, the mental health conditions, after the pandemic, during and after the pandemic particularly, there was a spike in a number of these conditions. Most of the ones that increased were what we call the common mental disorders. This hospital is officially a 550-bed hospital. We had been above that even before COVID, about 600 to 700 or 750. But with the advent of COVID-19, we started getting up to 1,000 people in admission. Actually, that was the first time we hit the 1,000 mark of people only in admission, not speaking about the outpatients, only people in admission. As we speak, we range in the 1,200 people in admission. So the effects are probably still going on.
This year, Parliament passed the Narcotics and Psychotropic Substances Control Bill 2023. Dr. Naku says this poses a big threat to this nation, not only morally but also economically.
We should not open up to drugs. We have a poor population, a very young population that is largely very dependent on very few people. If we open up on drugs and young people get into drugs, this country will never get out of poverty, because that is usually the effect of mass drug abuse. So our take as mental health practitioners was that we shouldn't open up.
Dr. Naku says Butabika is already full beyond capacity. She has advised anyone who undergoes mental challenges to seek help immediately. She also asked government to increase funding as a way of reducing the gap in the doctor-patient ratio. Relatedly, Mbara Regional Referral Hospital has joined the rest of the world to commemorate the World Mental Health Day. The hospital staff marked the day by visiting mental health patients and educating caretakers on how to handle these patients.
Yeah, what we want to show the world is that mental illness is real, mental illness is there. Mental health issues are there, and the services are also available.
We are working towards rectifying that Ministry of Health and all our partners to work together to make sure that that department is also catered for.
Medics have appealed to the Ministry of Health to increase the budget for mental health services as well as increase health workers specialized in mental health services. Report compiled by John Musenze and Abdulkarim Sengendo for the news.